right, before we start this evening, I'm going to ask everybody to please stand as we welcome our Year 12s into the venue. All right, please be seated and enjoy the first performance for this evening.
One, two, first one, two.
The hymn of heaven with angels and the saints. We gave us life beyond the grave. Holy, holy is the Lord. Holy, holy is the Lord. Holy, holy is the Lord.
Thank you, Chapel Band, for that performance. Good evening and welcome to our 2022 Secondary School Awards and Graduation Ceremony. My name is Matilda Sawyer and this is Matthew Clark, and we've had the honour of serving as school captains during our final year here at ACCM. I begin by officially welcoming our special guests, Mr. Lawson, our principal, Mr. Ian Stone, a representative from the school board, Mrs. Fraser, Ms. Flood, Mr. Ron Court from the Caboolture RSL, Mrs. City Constable from Sonta Caboolture, and Katrina Cruz from BPW Caboolture, teachers, parents, friends and families. Tonight, we come together as a school community and celebrate not only the achievements of our award winners, but all students have worked tirelessly throughout this academic year to overcome challenges, build character and accomplish personal goals.
Before we start our awards ceremony, could I please take a moment to go over a few housekeeping points? Restrooms are located to my right-hand side, your left, out the doors and down the corridor. In case of an emergency, centre staff will direct you through the exit doors and then to the assembly area. Please remain calm and follow their instructions. If first aid is required, please see Mrs. Sharrock at the side of the venue, and please ensure your mobile phones have been turned off or switched to silent mode. We'd also kindly ask families to be considerate of our students and to stay until the end of the ceremony.
To start proceedings, I'd like to acknowledge the fact that we are gathered on Gubbi Gubbi country. As we continue to learn to live together on these ancestral lands, we acknowledge and pay our respect to the elders, past and present, and pray that God will unite us all in a knowledge of his Son and in whom all things were created, in heaven and on earth, whether invisible or visible, for all things have been created through him and for him. Please welcome our Chappie Ian to the stage as he leads us all in our opening prayer.
Good evening, everyone. If you can please join me by bowing your heads, I'd like to pray. Dear Lord, we just thank you, Father, for this day, God, for the gathering of our seniors, our middle school cohort, God. We just thank you for all the families that are represented here, our school community here, our staff members. And God, we know through all the ups and downs that 2022 has brought, God, we thank you that you've brought us through to this day. I pray for your protection, your blessing. We pray for provision and success for our future graduates, Lord. And we just pray that tonight, God, would be a night that we can celebrate and commemorate. Lord, our secondary school here at ACC. God, we give you all the glory and praise for this evening, and we pray that you would go before us and be with us as we do. In Jesus' name, and everyone said, amen. I'd like to invite Ms. Flood. Can you please join me in welcoming her to the stage?
Thank you, Chappie. Well, again, good evening, everyone. Summer is definitely here, isn't it? I apologise. It does have aircon, and apparently it was service last week, but something's gone wrong today. My name is Michelle Flood, and I've been the Deputy Principal here at ACC now for about 4 years, so it's gone quite quickly. But it's kind of hard to see now that we're back here at awards night again after it just feels like yesterday we were just saying goodbye to the 2022 graduates. But tonight we get to say farewell to an amazing group of young men and women. We will be recognising effort, commitment and resilience, courage, individual achievement, Each student tonight will go home with a certificate, just marking the completion of another grade level. Year 12s, you will receive your college graduation certificates tonight, which you should all be deeply proud of. Form teachers have carefully selected students in each of their form classes to receive Christian Character Awards, Encouragement Awards, Most Improved Awards, School Community Awards, and we will be rewarding high academic success in each subject area as well. And there's quite a few specialty awards tonight. Although not everyone will receive a medal or a trophy, I would like to take this opportunity to congratulate all students for diligently working so hard this year. I congratulate those who improved grades, achieved personal bests, increased attendance, adjusted behaviour and attitude choices, led positively and stepped out of their comfort zones. Know that we are all proud of your efforts. And we give God the glory for all he has done in and through your lives. So without further delay, I would like to welcome to the stage our middle school coordinator, Ms. Chez Robbins, and she will be announcing the Year 7 to 9 award recipients, as well with our principal, Mr. Darren Lewis. So I might get the Year 7s to just line up and be ready, and we'll hand it over.
Thank you, Ms. Flood. I too want to extend a warm welcome to you all this evening, aware again of the genuine honour it is for me to journey with your children across the middle school years. As you no doubt know, parents, these years are typically filled with considerable change and multiple challenges as students are maturing and learning what it means to do life well. I really enjoy connecting with them in the daily. I enjoy hearing their truth and working with their teachers toward helping them to be the very best version of themselves. Middle school students, I want to say to you that I am proud of each one of you for your achievements this year. There is no doubt that you have all improved in some way, whether it's academically, in character, the development of a new skill or interest, growth spiritually, or strengthening of positive work habits. We want you to know we recognise all these achievements. So congratulations to you all on a successful year. To begin announcing specific awards reflective of our college values, I ask Mr. Isaac Scales and the students of 7A to join me on the stage. All right, so first of all, our Christian Character Award this evening goes to Tiffany Addison. The Encouragement Award, Abby Gleason. The Most Improved Award, Riley Gray. School Community Award goes to Tiger Mitchell. Subject Award for Year 7 Drama, Nikayla Galvin. Subject Award, Year 7 Mathematics, Isaac Garcia. And the subject award for Year 7 STEM goes to Aquol Nguyen. Please give all of these students a big round of applause. I now welcome Mr. Daniel Scarborough and the students of 7B to the stage. All right, the Christian Character Award in 7B goes to Samuel Hunter. The Encouragement Award and Subject Awards for Year 7 English, Year 7 Christian Living, Year 7 Dance, and Year 7 Economics and Business, Isabel State. She might need a bag to take those home. Most Improved Award for 7B, Onyx Karkari Bossi. The School Community Award goes to Falalele Andrews. The Subject Award, Year 7 Humanities and Year 7 Digital Technology, Harrison Aldous. And the Year 7 English Award, Joshua Politansky. Please congratulate all these students from 7B. I now welcome Mrs. Rebecca Alexander and her form class to the stage. All right, just while they're reorganising themselves. So this evening for 7C, the Christian Character Award, as well as the subject awards for Year 7 Japanese and Year 7 Economics and Business goes to Julia Roy. The Encouragement Award goes to Abby Higgins. The Most Improved Award, Cody Bruce. The School Community Award, Taumo'oi Andrews. The Subject Award for Year 7 Visual Arts, Justin Denham. Subject Award for Year 7 Japanese and Year 7 Science, Abriana Faramo. The Year 7 Award for Music, Oliver Shea. Please give all of these students from 7C a round of applause. I now welcome Miss Kirsty Symington, who is also our Year 7 team leader, and the students of 7D to the stage. All right, the Christian Character Award for 7D goes to Gladson Abraham. the Encouragement Award, Axel Jobling. Most Improved Award, Suana Moala. School Community Award, James Webb. Subject Award for Year 7 Health and Physical Education, Eldo Vinupal. And the Subject Award for Year 7 Food and Technology, William Greenwood. Please give these students a round of applause. Well done, Year 7. We are now going to move on to our Year 8s. And I invite Mr. James Smith and the students of 8A to the stage. So this evening for 8A, the Christian Character Award, together with the Subject Award for Year 8 Christian Living, Matilda Saibenga. The Encouragement Award for 8A goes to Matthew Highland. We will get that to Matthew. There we go. Let's congratulate Matthew again. Okay, and the Most Improved Award for 8A goes to Liam Andrews. The School Community Award, together with Subject Awards for Year 8 Health and Physical Education, Year 8 Digital Technology goes to Declan Bowson. The Year 8 STEM Award, together with the Year 8 Music Award, Abhinav Anil. And the Year 8 Food and Technology Award, Amelia Cutler. Please give these students a round of applause. And I now welcome Mrs. Eleanor Tocolo and the students of 8B to the stage. Okay, so the Christian Character Award for 8B goes to Kira Duez. The Encouragement Award, together with Subject Awards for Year 8 English, Year 8 Science, Year 8 Humanities, Year 8 Japanese, Year 8 Dance, haven't finished yet, and Year 8 Visual Arts goes to Jessica Jensen. The Most Improved Award, together with the award for Year 8 Christian Living, goes to Lily Shaw. The School Community Award goes to Benjamin Lottemau. And the Subject Award for Year 8 Drama this year goes to Alicia Cook. Please give these students a big round of applause. I now welcome Mrs. Erin White and her form class to the stage. All right, the Christian Character Award for 8C, together with Subjects Awards for Year 8 Mathematics, Year 8 Digital Technology, Year 8 Japanese, and Year 8 Economics and Business, Jaslyn Clark. The Encouragement Award, Elizabeth Aitken. Most Improved Award, Cooper Duez. And School Community Award, Dash Switzer. Please give all these students a big round of applause. As they leave, we now welcome our Year 9 students to the stage, beginning with Miss Elisa Jordan and her form class. Please welcome them to the stage. So this evening, for 9A, the Christian Character Award goes to Liam Niebling. The Encouragement Award, together with Subject Awards for Year 9 Hospitality, Year 9 STEM, and Year 9 Visual Arts, Edith Mulher. The Most Improved Award goes to Elijah Dolan. School Community Award, Gillian Comer. Subject Award for Year 9 Film and Television, Danielle Aldous. Subject Awards in Year 9 Health and Physical Education, together with Year 9 Sports Science, Ade Nguyen. Please give all these students a big round of applause. As they leave, I now welcome Mr. Mark Swadling and his form class to the stage. Okay, so the Encouragement Award for 9B goes to Taylor Gray. The Most Improved Award, Jake Hines. The School Community Award, Kendra Martin. Academic Award for Year 9 Science, Amy Henderson. Please give all these students a round of applause. And I now welcome to the stage Mr. Brian Doolin and the students of 9C. So the Christian Character Award, together with subject awards for Year 9 Mathematics and Year 9 Music, goes to Allegra Proctor. The Encouragement Award, Charlie George. The Most Improved Award, Lydia Richard. The School Community Award, together with subject awards in Year 9 Christian Living, Year 9 Japanese, and Year 9 Economics and Business, Eden Gale. Subject awards in both Year 9 English and Year 9 Drama, Ashley Montemayor. Subject award in Year 9 Dance, Amelia Mann. Subject awards in Year 9 Humanities, Year 9 Dance tied with Amelia, and also, Year 9 Dance is Delna Vinupal. And the subject award for Digital Technology, Caden Walls. Please congratulate these students as they leave the stage. Year 9 students, I just want to take the opportunity to wish you all the best as you enter into your senior schooling in our new building, I might add, next year. Can we just give all our Year 9 students one other round of applause? Thank you. You've almost finished middle school, still a couple of weeks to go. I would now like to invite our Year 7 dance group to the stage for their performance titled Lovely.
Always in my head space, but I know someday. faces, skin and bone. Hello, welcome home.
Good evening. My name's Anita Newell and I am the head of secondary. And first of all, I'd like to extend the apologies of Mr. Cameron Johnson, who is our senior coordinator and couldn't be here this evening. Can I invite those who are doing the awards to come up? Not yet, sorry. I wasn't prepared for this bit. First of all, I would really like to thank those, our arts department, both for that dance. I'd like to thank Alyssa Jordan for putting that together with our Year 7s. And I'm really excited by the things that are happening in our creative arts department and looking forward to even greater things in the future. So senior school, it's an exciting time. Every year it gets this time and I'm not quite sure how we got here. You're going to hear a lot of that tonight, I think. Year 10, 11 and 12 is the period where we start talking about what comes next, what comes after school. Up until that point, it just seems school lasts forever. It doesn't. And our Year 12s tonight know very well that it will end for them at the end of this week. We have amazing students in our senior school and it's my privilege to lead an amazing group of staff who do their very, very best each day to ensure that our students have all that they need in order to prepare themselves for the world outside. I congratulate every single student in our senior school for all that they have done. It doesn't matter which subjects you're taking, doesn't matter what particular pathway you are. If you are doing your best and you are achieving your best, then we congratulate you tonight. Not just those who will receive awards, but all of those of you who are working just as hard. But tonight we'll also acknowledge those receiving awards for contribution to school community, Christian character, encouragement, and most improved. I'd like to ask to the stage, Mrs. Fraser, the students of 10A to start off the Year 10 awards. Okay. For Christian, the Christian Character Award goes to Kai George. The Encouragement Award to Elizabeth Forster. The Most Improved to Jake Montalerone. The School Community Award to Dwight Croom. Yeah. Subject Award for Year 10 Psychology, Ziva Godfrey. Subject Award for Year 10 Modern History, Zachary Gator. I have a special mention for Freeman Gale, who's completed a Certificate 2 in Sport and Recreation. And a special mention to Richard Greenwood, who's completed a Certificate 3 in Aviation. Good job. Thank you, Year 10. I now welcome Miss Lucy Wells and 10B to the stage. Pretty cute. Okay. Christian Character Award goes to Grace Rampling. The Encouragement Award and the Subject Award for Year 10 Hospitality to Claire Heron. The Most Improved Award and Subject Award for Year 10 Film and TV, Taylor Mitchell. The School Community Award and Subject Award for Year 10 Mathematics to Eden Jackman. Subject Award for Year 10 Physics and Year 10 Legal Studies, as well as Gemma achieved 100% in 4 assessments, which is really awesome. And the Subject Award for Year 10 Creative Arts is Jemima Reneka. Subject Award for Year 10 STEM is Amaldev Benny. Please give these students a round of applause. I now welcome 10C to the stage with Mr. Vishina. Okay, the Christian Character Award and School Community Award go to Jason Murphy. The Encouragement Award to Hannah Carter. The Most Improved Award to Kiara Hine. Kiara. Okay, the Subject Award for Year 10 English, Year 10 Advanced Math, Year 10 Biology, and Year 10 Chemistry go to Soraya Gribben, who can't be here this evening. The Year 10 Physical Education Award and the Subject Award for Units 1 and 2 in Sport and Recreation to Talia Faith Bell. And the Year 10 Business Award to Cameron Zardo. Please give these and all of our Year 10s a round of applause. Well done. Okay, we're now moving on to our Year 10s. And I'd like to welcome all of our Year 10s to the stage, along with Mrs. Year 11, not Year 10, we've done that, along with Mrs. Samir Scarborough and Mr. Patrick Flaherty. Okay, our most improved award goes to Reese Andrews. And Isla Bailey has a special mention for completing a Certificate 2 in Health Support Services. I'd just like to take a minute and say that those certificate courses are not easy, and anyone who has achieved any of them has done extremely well. So our School Community Award and Subject Award for Units 1 and 2 Biology go to Jasmine Clark. Our Christian Character Award and Subject Award for Units 3 and 4, Sport and Recreation, goes to Joshua Hibbert. The Subject Award for Units 1 and 2, Modern History, and Subject Award for Units 1 and 2, Film and TV, and Units 1 and 2, Visual Arts, go to Jaylene Lemoyne. And another special mention, Alexander Mann has completed a Uni Head Start course in engineering. Very cool. Okay, Christian Character Award goes to Seth Martin, who has also completed a year-long work placement at Caboolture Baptist Church. The Encouragement Award and Subject Award for Units 1 and 2 General English goes to Charlotte McKee. The Award for Units 1 and 2 General Math goes to Audrey Mulhair. And the Units 1 and 2 Math Methods Award to Bevan Pagg. The School Community Award to Cindy Roberts. Yay. And the Encouragement Award goes to Molly Robinson. Please join me in a round of applause for you. Oh, hang on, we're not finished. Sorry. Apologies. I didn't turn the page. Okay, I knew there was something else. Okay, Units 1 and 2 Psychology, Units 1 and 2 Business, and Units 1 and 2 Legal Studies goes to Kiva Strachan. A special mention to Everett Sue, who has completed a Certificate 2 in Sport and Recreation. The award for Units 1 and 2 Literature goes to Aidan Templeton. Units 1 and 2 Physical Education Award goes to Justine Traor, who's also completed a Certificate 2 in Applied Fashion Design and Technology. The Most Improved Award, the Subject Award for Units 1 and 2 Essential English, and Units 1 and 2 Essential Math goes to Grace Wilson. Now we can congratulate all of our Year 11 students for this year. And I'd like to welcome Miss Flood back to the stage to present our specialty awards.
All right. Thank you, Mrs. Newell, and congratulations again to all our Year 7 to 11 students. This evening we will be presenting a variety of different specialty awards, ranging from the Creative Arts Awards to Long Tan to the highly acclaimed Ducks Award. Mr. Lawson, you're already up, so that's good. Students, if you are an award winner and I call out your name, please make your way up on the stage. And please remain on the stage until I've completed. All right, we'll start with the Creative Arts Awards. So the Creative Arts Awards is determined by the Arts Coordinator in consultation with teachers in the arts field. One student has been selected from middle school and a senior school cohort. The recipient of this award has demonstrated high ability and great effort across a range of school-based and extracurricular arts activities. They have shown a high level of artistic skills across the arts areas, and they have consistently given of their best efforts and also helped encourage others to do their best. So the Middle School Creative Arts Award goes to Danielle Aldis. And the Senior School Creative Arts Award goes to Jemima Renica. The next award is the USC Rise and Shine Award. A University of Sunshine Coast Rise and Shine recipient is an enthusiastic leader in the school and community and shines in their learning through effort, passion, and innovation. Two Year 10 students will receive a certificate of recognition from USC, an awards packet which includes a journal and a $50 voucher to assist with their future study to help them get the equipment that they will need. One student isn't here tonight, but the two award winners are Talia Faith Bell and Saria Gribben. Talia's coming. Please congratulate Talia. All right, we now move to the Zonta Banksia Award, and tonight we warmly welcome Mrs. City Constable to the stage. She's a member of the Zonta Club at Caboolture. Yeah, give her a round of applause. And she will present a special certificate and a gift to one of our Year 11 female students. The aim of this award is to recognise the personal achievements of the selected student who has endured adversity but conducted themselves with integrity, commitment and fortitude. The student that will be receiving this award has displayed a strong sense of self-responsibility, tenacity and resilience. And the award tonight goes to Audrey Mulhare. Well done, Audrey. Just before you go. We just wanted to thank you, Sita, for coming out this afternoon, this evening, and we just got a small gift for you. Thank you very much. All right, I would now like to welcome to the stage Mr. Ron Court, a representative from the Caboolture RSL, who will be presenting the next award, which is the 2022 Spirit of Anzac Award. This award is given to a Year 9 student who has demonstrated qualities of leadership, teamwork, values, problem-solving, resourcefulness, communication skills, and cooperation and community involvement. And I believe the award is an iPad. Is that right? And the award goes to Liam Niebling. All right, I'm going to ask Mr. Ron Court to stay on stage to present the next two awards. The next one is the Long Tan Youth Leadership and Teamwork Award. The awards program has been created to acknowledge the achievements of young people who have demonstrated outstanding qualities of leadership and teamwork within our school and the wider community. Leadership and teamwork are underpinned by qualities such as supporting others and doing the best you can, which are the values the ADF shares with the broader community. So this evening, a student from Year 12 has been selected to receive this prestigious award. The student has demonstrated an ability to positively influence others and achieve goals. And they will be receiving a certificate as well as $500. The award goes to Miss Flood? No. The award goes to Ethan Preston Turnbull. You can share that with Mum and Dad, yeah? Yeah. Yeah. Well done, Ethan. The next award is actually a new award. Where are you going? I can still boss him around for a week, yeah? So the next, is a new award. It's the ADF Future Innovators Award. And for the first time, we are taking part in this award. It is open to Australian high school students currently completing Year 10. The award will recognise recipients' science and mathematics abilities while highlighting the value the Navy, Army and Air Force place on STEM skills and STEM career opportunities within the defence. There will be approximately 5,000 recipients across Australia. Applicants must demonstrate motivation, innovation, and achievement in the field of STEM, and the Year 10 recipient tonight will receive a prize of $250. And this award goes to Amaldev Benny. Well done, Amaldev. That's great. Thank you, Mr. Ron Court, for attending. I know you have to go off to another one. We just have a thank you gift there showing our appreciation. Please thank Mr. Ron Court. All right, it gives me great pleasure to now welcome to the stage Miss Katrina Cruz, who is attending our award ceremony on behalf of the Business and Professional Women BPW Caboolture. Miss Cruz will be presenting the recipient of the 2022 PBW Business Award. The PBW Caboolture has been active in the community for over 30 years, They are a part of PPW Australia and PPW International. BPW offered to award one of our senior business students who has displayed excellence in business and demonstrated a growth mindset. The award consists of a certificate of recognition together with, is it 100? It's gone up. 200. Gift card for their effort. So the award goes to Cameron Zardo. Please congratulate Cameron as she comes up. Thank you for coming tonight. We just have a small bunch of flowers to give you just to say thank you. All right, another new award this year is from the Moreton Bay Regional Council Mathematics Excellence Award. And this award is called, this award will be presented to a secondary student who has demonstrated a positive attitude towards improving their numeracy skills throughout the year, shown enthusiasm for the subject of mathematics beyond the classroom, and displayed a willingness to encourage and help others. And we're good to go. The student is already on the stage, Audrey Mulhair. She's coming back. She went and sat down. Next is the Principals Award. So the Principals Award is given every year to worthy recipients who have made exemplary contributions to the college during the school year. The award winners have followed the college rules, demonstrated high academic achievement, independence, and a consistent effort and attitude to learning. The Middle School Principal Award this year goes to Eden Gale. And the Senior School Principals Award goes to Tasia Wicks. Next is the AMPOL All-Rounder Award. This year marks the 38th year of the prize. That gives schools the opportunity to recognise a final year student considered to be a genuine all-rounder, someone who excels in their studies, possesses leadership qualities and a good attitude, and is keen to serve their community. The award includes a medallion and an award certificate and a letter of congratulations. And this award goes to Tiara Stokes. All right, please give all of these young men and women a round of applause as they leave the stage. All right, we come to the final one, which is the Ducks Award. The College Ducks is awarded to the top academic achiever in Year 12 based on results earned in their final year of schooling. The Academic Ducks this year will be awarded to a student completing general subjects and has been working towards achieving an ATAR. This award is not awarded lightly. Many hours of hard work and dedication go into achieving such high academic results. The 2022 Ducks Award winner goes to George Matthew. Keep clapping. It deserves it. All right. No, you can go. Thanks, George. We now move on to the part of the ceremony where we announce the 2022 middle school and senior school leadership teams. But firstly, I would like to acknowledge and celebrate the student leaders this year across secondary school, an amazing bunch of young students that did their absolute best, gave of their time, made decisions, and invested in our school community. We honour you and sincerely thank you for your contributions. The 2022 middle school and senior school student leaders have been elected by the college leadership team as well as their peers to lead the student body in various aspects of school culture in 2023. Students, when your name is called, please make your way to the stage and remain on stage until we have finished announcing the positions. So we're going to start with the middle school sports leaders. For Garland Eagles, Elizabeth Atkin and Jenching Gradwell, is that right? For Noble Brumbies, Aquol Nguyen and James Webb. For McConnell Rams, Kiana Bartlett-Cash and Stevie Santo. And for Oxley Lions, Amber Shivey and Reed Sadler. Yeah. Pays to keep your jackets on, yeah? All right, the middle school peer support leaders for 2023, Jaslyn Clark, Tiger Mitchell, Tiffany Addison, Julia Roy, and Amelia Cavill. The middle school creative arts leaders, Matthew Hyland, Zachary Neeby, and Catherine Hines. The middle school chapel leaders, Chelsea Northcott, Indiana Paul, and Sasha Hibbert. And last but not least, our two middle school leaders for 2023, Jessica Jensen and Declan Boson. Please give all our middle school senior leaders for 2023 a big round of applause. Jessica, you want to wait that way? You can leave now. Good leader. There you go. Quick. Excellent leaders. Good start. Excellent. All right, our 2023 senior student leadership team. Students, again, when I call your name, please make your way to the front. We'll start with the house captains. The Garland Eagles house captains, Michaela Walter and Reese Andrews. the Noble Brumbies House Captains, Akuj N.A. and Riley Murdoch. The McConnell Rams House Captains, Ella Abbott and Liam Niebling. And the Oxley Lions House Captains, Jasmine Clark and Hamish Lister. The Shadow Crew Captain for 2023, Xander Yates. Yay. The Faith and Service Captains. We actually will have three next year. Elizabeth Forster, Seth Martin and Kai George. The Vice Captains for 2023, Audrey Mulhare and Bevan Pang. And I'm going to invite Matilda Sawyer and Matthew Clark to the stage to hand badges to the new 2023 school captains. Okay, the school captains for 2023, Joshua Hibbert and Justine Traor. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you the 2023 Student Leadership Team. All right, Justine, you can lead the team. Well done. All right, I'm now going to invite Matilda Sawyer and Matthew Clark, our outgoing student leaders, to give a school captain's address. Please put your hands together.
Wow. I want to start by saying I can't believe that after 8 years here at ACC, I would be graduating with a class full of the most incredible people. The day I shyly and very anxiously walked in through Ms. Marzieski's Year 5 classroom, I was blown away with the amount of kindness I was met with by people who would be graduating along with me today and by people who have become some of my best mates. Yes, the 8 years have been a journey, but it has been a journey worth the while. As teachers, classmates, camps, excursions, athletics days, cross countries, and overall some of the most best and worst days have come and gone, we have been able to make memories that will stay with us forever. I'm so truly grateful I have been able to make some of the coolest friends, have some of the most unique conversations, and learn some of the most important and kind of pointless stuff. Yeah, that's math class. But like, actually, thanks to Mrs. Elliot for teaching me how to calculate how many marks I needed to pass overall. With that being said, I'd like to direct the next part to our senior school students. In the scheme of things, it doesn't matter if you are classified as an academic student or not. It doesn't matter if you're really good at sports or not. And yes, we are at awards night, and it would be good to be recognized for all of our hard work, effort, and dedication for what we have achieved this year. But in all honesty, it doesn't matter if you receive an award or badge. Awards and badges don't define who you are. They don't define who you will be in the future. What truly matters is your character. People will forget what you said, and people may forget what you did, but people will never forget how you made them feel. So no matter what leadership position you now hold, or no matter your future academic or sporting achievements, I hope all senior school, especially the oncoming Year 12 and the graduating Year 12s, live every day with compassion, kindness, and courage. But most importantly, I hope you guys find people that support, encourage you as you move through your remaining senior school years, and for some start a new chapter in life. Because I know that if it wasn't for the endless amount of support given to me by my friends, teachers, and family, especially my mum, I wouldn't have been able to become the person I am today and have achieved what I have. I want to say thank you to my classmates for making the stresses of school way more bearable. I would like to say thank you to Mrs. Newell for replying to my emails at 2 a.m. in the morning and not questioning me. I would like to say thank you to Miss Roadigger for always being there cheering us on from the sideline. I'd like to say thank you to Miss V for being Miss V, always encouraging, supporting, and giving us all that she has. And I'd like to say thank you to all my teachers and all of my fellow classmates, parents, caregivers, and family that have supported us these last couple of years. But most of all, I'd like to say thank you to my mum for believing in me and supporting me. Thank you for showing me that anything is achievable, and thank you for working so hard to give me and my sisters all the opportunities we have had. I love you, Mama. Thank you.
Thank you, Tilly. I'd like to say a huge thank you to everyone for coming here tonight. Yes, it was mandatory, but we are still glad you're here. Our journey through these last few years hasn't exactly been an easy one, and our year has endured through a lot, both as individuals and as a cohort. And while class hasn't always gotten along, I can proudly say that we helped each other when it mattered. There are several students here who I once thought I would never get along with, and have since found myself joking around and having fun conversations with them. Our cohort has been there for each other when it was really needed, and I'm really honored to have shared so many wonderful moments with you guys. Thank you for everyone who helped make school a lot more bearable for me. Whether it was helping with content, sharing a joke, a conversation, even if it was something small, please know you really did make a difference to my high school education. For my friends, who I spent many, many lessons joking around with and learning to, I'm really glad to have met you guys, and I'm really looking forward to seeing you guys outside of school. Well, one of our main focuses tonight is on our cohort, graduating, I would like to say a massive thank you to the staff as well. Thank you to all the teachers I've had throughout these past couple years. I'm blessed to have shared classes, mountains of practice exams, and many jokes with you guys too. The effort you put into our class through this year hasn't gone unnoticed. Investing all that time, money, and probably blood, sweat, and tears is something that we as a cohort were blessed with, and we appreciate you for it. Thank you to our parents, guardians, and whoever else contributed to our high school experience. I really wouldn't have made it through this last year without my family, especially my parents. Your support, consideration, and many burrito nights have helped me more than you guys realize. I'm blessed to have you as my parents. For those of you who don't know my parents, if you look over somewhere there, my mom is out there crying, and dad is probably trying to record the video. Thank you both so much for everything you guys have done for me. Finally, I'd like to address the Year 12s of 2023. Next year is your last year here, so make sure you guys enjoy it. It's going to be one of the hardest years for many of you, so enjoy all the good moments. Next year, you'll be the cohort that everyone else looks up to. So please lead by example, which I'm sure you all will. Please remember that leadership isn't just about a badge. You all have something to contribute, so don't feel like you can't share your ideas if you didn't get the leadership position you wanted. You have the power to make a difference. Those of you who do have badges, you have taken up a responsibility to represent your year, and in many cases, your entire school. Don't let this opportunity go to waste. Listen to your cohort and help get their ideas running. I will now hand over to Mrs. Newell for Year 12 awards and graduation.
I think I need this tool. Thank you, Matthew and Tilly, for those beautiful words and for making this a special night for your cohort. Okay, those who, yep, we organising the chairs? I believe so. Perfect. Awesome. Year 12. It's actually a lot about you tonight. It's another last. We've had lots of them. We've had last swimming carnivals, last sports carnivals, last cross country. Tomorrow we'll do our last excursion, but tonight we do our last awards night, your last awards night with us. And on Friday, you'll have your last assembly as we say goodbye, which is always very sad. Tonight we celebrate each of you, all that you have brought of yourselves to the college, and all that you will take of us out into the rest of the world. We need you to know that we appreciate each and every one of you, that you are all unique and made in God's image. And we pray that you will be blessed by what you have been part of here, and that you will be a blessing to all those you come in contact with beyond. On Friday, it'll be a time to say farewell. On Friday, it'll be a time to end your schooling with us. But tonight, we're going to celebrate all that you've achieved this year. We're going to celebrate all that hard work. We're going to celebrate the tears, of which there were many. We're going to celebrate all that you have done and achieved in this year together. But before I start, it's important to also acknowledge that we thank God for all he's done in your lives, not just through this year, but through your whole journey. Year 12 is a culmination of 13 years of school. Whether you did them all here or elsewhere, that's 13 years. That's a long time. And you made it, which is awesome. Year 12s, as your name is called, please make your way up to the stage to receive your Year 12 certificate and take your place on stage. Take a seat, that is. Oh, this is always hard. This is the last time we kind of do a roll call, guys. Okay. Alvin Abalash. Who is also receiving the Most Improved Award. Suey Andrews, who gets a special mention, who has completed a school-based traineeship, which is awesome. Misha Armfield, who is tonight receiving an award for Units 3 and 4 Business and Units 3 and 4 Legal Studies. Amisha also gets a special mention for completing a University of Sunshine Coast Head Start course in journalism. Ella Bailey, Wade Baker. Karen Belcher. Caitlin. What am I saying? Caitlin Belcher. Mitchell Bromley, who's completed a Certificate 2 in Plumbing. Matthew Clark, who's tonight receiving an award for Christian Character and subject awards for Units 3 and 4 General Math and Units 3 and 4 Psychology. Holly Darlington. Holly has completed a Certificate 2 in Animal Studies. Hayley Duez. Hayley's completed a Certificate 2 in Health Support Services, which is awesome. Chloe Forster. And Chloe is receiving our School Community Award tonight. Sarah Joyce Foley. Luke Gaskey, who's completed a Certificate 2 in Hospitality. Sarah Gregory. Matthew Harbers. Ryan Hardwick. Kyan Hunt. Great. Mana Aromi. Eric Jepson, who has a special mention for completing a Certificate 1 in Construction. Alexis Chitilakan. Alexa has also completed a Certificate 3 in Health Service Assistance. Jared Kircher. Jared gets the Subject Award for Units 3 and 4 Modern History. Jaden King. Tonight, Jaden is receiving the Encouragement Award and Subject Award for Units 3 and 4 Essential Math. And the 3 and 4 Essential English and 3 and 4 Tourism. Well done. George Matthew. Okay, George is receiving the Subject Awards for Units 3 and 4 General English, Units 3 and 4 Mathematical Methods, Units 3 and 4 Physics, and he's also been awarded the Australian Institute of Physics Certificate for Excellence in Physics. And George has received a raw result for all of his internal assessment of 90% or higher. That deserves that. Jasper McIlvray. Lily Parkinson. Ethan Preston Turnbull. Sarah Savikov. Sarah. Sarah is also receiving the Subject Award for Units 3 and 4 Biology, 3 and 4 Chemistry, and she's also been awarded the Royal Australian Chemical Institute Certificate of Excellence in Chemistry, and she achieved a raw result for her internal assessment of 90% or higher. Matilda Sawyer. Matilda's tonight receiving Christian Character Award, as well as the Subject Award for Units 3 and 4 Biology, 3 and 4 Physical Education, and 3 and 4 Religion and Ethics. Lily Sexton. Yeah. Lily is also receiving the Subject Award for Units 3 and 4 Essential Math and has a special mention for completing a Certificate 2 in Community Services. Phoebe Sillins-Lobley. Phoebe is receiving our School Community Award. Michael Smith. Tiara Stokes. Tiara is also receiving the Subject Award for Units 3 and 4, Film, Television and New Media. Isabel Sullivan. Tasia Wicks. And last but by no means least, Harrison Walter. Please join me in congratulating our 2022 graduates. It gives me great pleasure to now welcome our college principal, Mr. Jared Lawson.
Thank you, and I won't be long, but the reason we do this, and I know it has been a long night, is because this is a very important occasion. It is the end for our graduates of a very important season in your life. You can split your life up into a lot of chapters, as many as you want. You could give it 8 or 10. You can narrow it down to 5 or 4 or 3. Or if you even took it down to 2, you'd probably just separate it between childhood and adulthood. And literally, while there's other markers, probably the end of school is like the most common one. So I think it was only 35 years ago when I was on stage that I suddenly realised that it was actually important when they started telling us how important it was. Up to now, you haven't had many choices in life. You've had a few, but you've been told what to wear in the morning, whether to have your socks pulled up or not. Your choices have sort of been, do I take geography or do I take legal studies? But literally, from now on, you've got the world at your feet. You've got as many choices or places you can go or things you can do. So it's quite a momentous occasion, and that's why we have this formal ceremony. So firstly, I'd just like to say congratulations to all the Year 12s. Even though some of you might not have put 100% effort in for 13 years, every single one of you have put quite a lot of effort in. You can't get through 13 years of school without a lot of effort. So can you join me first just in congratulating these Year 12s for all the things they have done? Now, I just say there's actually one group of people here who have put in more effort than these Year 12s, and I'm going to ask them to stand up. If you are a parent or carer of one of these graduates, could you please stand? And just stay standing for a second. This group of people have, as you heard from the two school captains who were able to speak, this group of people have loved you, have supported you, have spent a lot of money on school fees, have got you up in the morning, have taken you to sport, have taken you to many things. So for 13 years, for 17, for 18 years, they've looked after you and brought you to this place. So I just ask the Year 12 graduates to stand to just thank their parents and give them a round of applause. Thank you. You may be seated. Look, this is a celebration. Yeah, and occasionally there's a couple of tears at what's being gone, but it's also ascending out. So we look forward to hearing amazing stories of your success. As you go out, our prayer is that you succeed in all that you put your hand to, that you go well, that you prosper. Look, we're from a Christian college, and I know that there's some of you that know God, and we pray that as you go out, you just find him more faithful than you ever knew he could be, that he's someone who sticks closer than a brother, that he's someone who you can depend and rely on. And for those of you who don't yet know him, we pray that at one day you remember some of the things you heard here and you reach out to him, because Scripture says he's not far from any one of us. So, look, we look forward to hearing all your stories of success. We thank you for your time at ACC. You've actually been a great cohort. I've only been here this last year, but when I listen to stories from teachers and other staff, you've had a very positive input into the life of the college. You've left a legacy, so we thank you very much for that. And we just look forward to hearing stories of your success in the future. So thank you very much. Congratulations. And look, I'm actually going to invite Miss Flood back to the stage just to lead them in the hat tossing competition. Miss Flood's been here since some of you who started in prep, so I'll invite her back to the stage for this final part of the award ceremony. Hang on, before we do, let me just pray for you as you go out. If I could just ask you to bow your heads and close your eyes, we'll just pray for this cohort of Year 12s. Father, we thank you, Lord God, for every student here and every family they represent. Lord, we just pray you bless them as they go out. We pray you protect them, you put your hand over them, you guide them, Father God. Lord, and you have purposes and plans for them, and they're plans for good. And we pray that everyone would find those purposes and plans, that whatever they do, whatever they put their hands to, you would bless, Father. We thank you for the privilege of having them at this school. And we just pray, bless them in the future, in Jesus' name. And everybody said, amen.
Just getting out of the way. Yes, it's an exciting night. Put your hand up if you've ever been in Miss Flood's office for one reason or another. Yeah, a few of you. I know them, some of them quite well. But it's been a joy. Each one of you are very special to us, and it's been so wonderful to celebrate this evening with you. Before we do our cup throwing, I'll get you to put all your lovely certificates and things underneath so you don't trample on them. And while students do that, I just want you to join me in thanking the Morrowfield Sports and Events Centre staff who have worked tirelessly to help us with this event. And when you leave, please remember to take all your water bottles and programs and any rubbish around in your area. That will help them greatly when we do a pack up later. I'm going to ask parents of Year 12, if you want to come down to the front to take photos, now's a good opportunity to do that. And just a reminder, at the end of the ceremony, Year 12, you need to return your cap and gown. So when it does go up, you need to go and find it and then return it. Also, when I dismiss you, we have a couple of photo booths if you want to grab a photo. We've got a backdrop over there. We've got a backdrop over there. You can come over here as well. And students in Year 7 to 11, thank you for your outstanding behaviour tonight. I know it's been hot in this auditorium, but it's been wonderful to have you all join us this evening. And we will see you at school tomorrow morning at 8:30. All right. I'll get you to stand, come closer. Can I just get someone to put that speaker down, please? Isaac, can you just grab that speaker? Yep. So come closer. Don't take your cap off now, Izzy. You've got to put it on your head. All right, so there'll be a countdown. Let's see if you're good at maths, hey? All right, so I'm going to go one, two, three, and then throw. All right? Suey, you've got to have your hat on your head. And then grab it, and then off. All right, we ready, parents? One, two, three, throw! Well done, Year 12s. Congratulations, and thank you, everyone, for coming tonight. Well done, Jasper. Good job. Good job, Alan. Good job.